Yo, what is good, everybody? I hope you're doing good today, and welcome back to another episode on the Wave Wednesdays.
Wave. It's lit on a Wednesday, yeah. Wave. It's lit on Wave Wednesdays, yeah.
So guys, if you're here watching this right now, thank you so much for clicking on this video, and I really hope you guys enjoy. As you guys saw in the title of the video, I'll be teaching you guys how to make a YouTube video. I did a video like this a while back on how I make my music, or just in general on how to make a song, and I know I helped a lot of people because there's artists that watch my stuff. So now if there's other creators that watch my videos, I'll be helping you guys out in how to create videos. Okay, so the first step is grab a camera, a phone, anything you have that you can record something on. Don't think just because you don't have a good quality camera or your phone is not that good that you're not going to be able to create something good. Especially if you're just starting out, the best thing to do is just create. So if you're waiting just because you don't have that one thing, then you're wasting a lot of time and you're not gonna do anything. And guys, Apple phones nowadays, if you have the iPhone 10, 11, or 12, whatever you have, the camera quality is still pretty good. So yeah, that's step one, and it's an obvious one. Obviously, just grab something that you can record with. So step two is come up with a theme or ideas of your video. What I recommend most of you doing, which I know a lot of artists do, and I do this myself as an artist too, which I also said in the last video on how to make a song. For music, usually when you're trying to create something that you want to create, usually you can go listen to other people's music, your favorite artist's music, see what they do, listen to what they do, listen to their lyrics, get ideas from their work, which is called inspiration. I find when I work best is when I'm inspired by something or someone. For example, if you're an artist and you're not really feeling it that day, go listen to some of your favorite artists, listen to their music, bump out to it, get hyped, get inspired by it, and then try getting into the studio. It'd be a lot more easier instead of just going and like you don't know what to write, like you're not feeling it. That's the exact same thing I do with YouTube videos. I watch all my favorite creators every night, watching all their old videos, new videos, getting ideas, getting inspiration from them, seeing how they put together clips to create something so good. And these are some of the themes you could do. Gaming videos, prank videos, challenge videos, daily vlogging, tutorial videos, advice videos like this. Literally, there's a lot of things you can do, especially just starting out. You want to kind of touch the tips of every single one. And then you see which one engages your audience more. And obviously the videos that your audience is liking more, those are the videos you want to try to push towards more. But if you're still not sure yet, it's all good to keep on making all kinds of videos at first. After you come up with your theme and stuff, you can even write it down so you remember it, or just so you have it in your head. Before you start recording, obviously play it on your head a bit. What am I gonna say? What am I gonna do? Where should I have the camera set up? Should I do this shot here, then this shot there? Come up with different types of movements to keep it interesting. There are also some people that are just really good at talking in front of a camera that they don't really need to do all that stuff before, but if you're not one of those people, you know, set it up in your head. Like I said, write it down, take it through slowly. It's okay if there's cuts. It doesn't always have to be one whole shot. And then after you got your camera, you've been inspired, you've got what your idea of your video you're doing, then just put the camera down, press record, and do your thing. Make sure to be yourself, guys, be funny, and just be entertaining to watch. And don't think, oh my god, well my life is boring, nobody's gonna want to watch my daily vlogs or this and that. Trust me guys, if you're putting in work, you're doing things right, you're keeping it consistent, you're putting out good content, people are gonna watch. And second of all, don't even think about the viewers, just make it for what you want to make. Make it because you enjoy making it, and the people watch, that's a bonus. The same goes for streaming, guys. Streaming is awesome. If I grow a little bit more, maybe I'll start a stream, but I know a lot of people who want to start streams too, so I'll give you some advice about streaming. So it's almost the same exact thing, guys. You can stream a lot of things, but obviously the most popular is probably gaming. So when you're first starting out, see, like I said, you want to come up with a theme of your streams. What do you want your vibe of the stream to be? You want it to be a happy stream, just a stream where like you're talking to people, you know, some advice streams, gaming streams, or maybe just like watching videos on the internet, or some people even like to do something entertaining where they go on Omegle. Like I said though, you don't have to go too niche at the beginning. From the start, you can try everything. Try playing Minecraft one day, playing Fortnite one day, playing Call of Duty one day, playing like NHL or FIFA or NFL, anything like that. But do it for a bunch of weeks straight. Even do 3 days, okay, I'm playing COD. 3 days I'm playing NHL. 3 days I'm playing NBA. Keep on testing it out, like I said, and whichever ones are getting the most viewers, that's what people want to see and come back to. So start thinking, okay, if people like to watch more sports games, then I'm going to start playing more sports games. If people like to watch me play combat games, then I'm going to play more combat games. And same goes for all the other ones. Another thing, guys, also especially with streaming, you want to engage with your audience. If people are talking in your chat, being there, appreciating you, you know, talk back to them. If they're asking some questions, answer their questions, etc. And yeah, just have some fun, vibe out, chill with your stream viewers, and just chill with your friends that you're playing with, and have an overall good time. So yeah, guys, don't think it over too much. Don't think like, oh yeah, what am I gonna do, this, that. Just put down the camera and film something. Now, I really hope I could have inspired some of you guys who want to start streaming or want to start making videos, or even artists, because I put a little bit of an artist thing in there. Or if you haven't seen my video on how I make my songs or how I make a song, go check that one out too. Next week, guys, we probably have another cooking video coming, and I'm going to try an Omegle video. It's going to be fun. And yeah, guys, if you have any video ideas you want to see, just tell me personally or just put it in the comments. Say like, hey, you want to do this video? Try this video. I want to see this. And yeah, guys, so I kept this one short and sweet. I really hope you guys enjoyed this one. If you did, make sure to smash a like down below and subscribe to my channel and even turn on my post notifications. So one thing to take from this video is just do. Keep it simple. Like they say, keep it simple, stupid. Just have some fun with it. Don't stress so much. And yeah, take something from this, learn from it, use it, and I wish you guys all the best. That's all I got for you guys today. I'll make sure to see you on Friday Funday. Peace out. Hey, turn your phone off, take your clothes off. I'm a savage, but I fuck it to a slow song. Turn the lights down, lay the pipe down.